It's a unique take on Armadillomon. How did you do the voice?
Oh, well, I wrote with the director. The director wanted somebody from Texas. I don't know how he got there, whether I suggested it or he suggested it, or we just evolved it together. And Armadillomon Digivolve 2 just came out. It was my voice, very mellow. I wanted something mellow. It was my voice down in my fairly lower, middle to lower register. And that's what we worked out. And when we did it, I did the audition, and they said, oh, perfect, perfect. So, I didn't say much. He was on screen a lot, but he was a man of few words. He was always saying, I gotta take a nap. He was always sleepy. Now, Wizardmon, speaking into the microphone and cupping the ear, you have some very talented announcers working that way, and very talented actors and actresses doing drama and comedy over the radio, because it was on television. And that's where the term voiceover came about. Any voice thing that you don't see the person, or you see the person but they're expressing thoughts, as in a movie where the guy's narrating what you see in action on the screen. The earliest voiceover that I did an audition when I was 19 for what turned out to be, when I was 19, I was going to college, and I decided to switch to night school and go look for a job in Manhattan during the day in show business, some kind of show business field.
Mr. Axelrod?
Yeah.
Where did you live before you moved to Manhattan?
I lived in Queens most of my life.
Oh, really? Like me?
Yeah.
Awesome.
Flushing and Bayside.
Flushing and Bayside, really?
Yeah. It's like I'm home now. This is great.
Awesome.
I live in L.A. now. I've been in L.A. since 1975. My heart is in New York, so it's great to be back. I knocked on the door. Nice Japanese gentleman answered and invited me in and asked me if I did cartoon voices. Nice. I was an actor, so I knew when to say yes. So I said, oh, sure, I do cartoon voices. Yeah. So he asked me to do a little audition, and I just sat down with a Wallensack tape recorder. So that was my first foray into voiceovers, and he actually offered me a job in Japan doing cartoon voices. And I was very intimidated by going overseas. I was only 19. And in my day, it didn't grow up as fast as you do now. I think the kids are growing up very fast. Just with computers, more sophistication. In my day, when you grew up at 19, you went into partying, growing your hair long. So I didn't want to leave that, and I was also a hockey player.
Oh, really?
I didn't want to leave hockey, and so I turned it down. Little did I know that 10 years later I'd be doing the exact same thing, doing English voices from Japanese cartoons, but in Los Angeles. So the first voiceover job I had of that nature, anime, was on a show called Banner the Squirrel. It was in 1980, I guess. That's a lot of years ago.